Welcome back. Now, the Swedish singing sisters Klara and Johanna Soderberg have performed for royalty, prime ministers, and they've sold out the Royal Albert Hall.
Yes, and when they were looking for a name to call themselves, they decided on First Aid Kit because they wanted to make people feel better.
They're about to take their third album on a summer tour. We're going to chat to them soon, but first, take a look at one of their tracks, Walk Unafraid.
As the sun comes up, as the moon goes down, these heavy notions creep around, it makes me...
So Klara and Johanna are both with us this morning.
Morning.
Welcome. And extra delighted because you've got the guitar with you.
Yes.
Which implies that you might be about to sing something.
Maybe.
Really? Do you know what's funny is that, and I think it's so delightful, quite a lot of artists come in here. Sometimes we ask them to sing, sometimes they don't. It's entirely their decision. But, you know, singing early in the morning is not everyone's cup of tea. But you're happy to do it.
Yes. Any time of day.
We're just kind of used to singing whenever, really.
Okay. Yeah. And are you going to play something for us now? Can we do that straight away?
Yeah,
is that okay?
Sure.
What is it you're going to do for us?
It's one of our songs. It's called Master Pretender.
Master Pretender. And you're going to give us a little bit?
Yeah.
Yes.
Lovely.
I never thought that I was weak. Always thought I could get hurt pretty bad. Still get up on my own 2 feet. I always believed that I was free. That I had some sense of integrity that would rise above whatever tried to change me. But honey, now I won't wait for something to bring me round and smile. 'Cause that only sticks for a while, then I'm back again. Oh, I'm a master pretender.
That was lovely.
That was beautiful. Who wrote that?
We did. Yeah.
But I mean, I meant out of you two, actually. Do you do all the writing together, all the music together?
Most
Does someone
of it.
Have a particular
yeah,
role?
Yeah, I mean, I usually start writing the songs, and then I get stuck, and then we work on it together.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's great to have someone like that you can just
trust.
Yeah, yeah. It's because it's sometimes when you're writing songs, you just think, I have no idea what to do, and it's great to just have someone that has the
tells
exact...
you if it's good or not.
Yes.
Are you
and
very
is,
frank?
And is brutally you, honest
I'm very honest.
That.
Okay.
Sometimes too honest, I think.
And okay, well, that's a good thing. I suppose that's creatively, that can be a good thing as well.
Yes.
But now, tell us a little bit about your backstory, because you started performing when you were very young. You were talking, what, 12, 13 years old?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. 14, 16 when we started performing live.
Yeah.
Right.
We've been doing this ever since.
And you started putting your work out there, and then various people saw you, and things developed quite quickly, didn't they?
Yeah.
I mean, I think so, but it was still... It's all happened very gradually still, so it doesn't feel, you know,
it was an overnight success, but it's been...
But it was still overwhelming, these tiny, you know, when
tiny
we started
steps
out.
Perhaps a bit more satisfying, though.
Yeah,
maybe,
exactly.
Because you know what you're building up to, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
You know, it's interesting, you pick up from each other's sentences and you answer at the same time. And what's really interesting, when we were doing our research, is you two don't actually live in the same country.
Yeah.
At the moment. Yet you're still so connected. And so what's the situation? You've come over, you're based in Manchester at the moment. And Johanna, you're based in?
Stockholm, Sweden.
In Stockholm, Sweden. So are you writing over the phone? Are you Skyping?
We actually wrote a song through Skype.
Yeah.
Did you?
We have.
Yes. But we're always on tour, so we're always together. It's kind of good that when we're not on tour, we're in separate countries.
Did you ever feel as if you were in and out of each other's pockets? It just all got a little bit too much.
Yeah, and we're sisters. You know, we've always been together.
We lived together our whole lives until I moved here. You know, so like we moved out of our parents' house and lived together. You know, so it was,
I
know you've had an enormous success in America, and I mean, people listening to you, had they not heard our introduction, would not know you're Swedish. You sound very Americanized, your voices.
Yes.
Is that because that was just how you were taught English, or is that because you sing in a country style makes you sound quite American?
I don't know, it doesn't feel, for us to speak like Swedish accent, you know, it doesn't feel natural to us.
Well, you do it quite well.
You do it very well.
You know, it's just...
And to do a British accent is also very hard, so... No, that was really bad.
That was quite good as well.
Oh my God, bad
I'm sorry.
But it's just, is that something that fits in because you sing?
I think it's because of the music. A lot of what we listen to is from America and just growing up with, like, Simpsons.
Yeah.
And
do you do any of your songs in Swedish? Do you sing in Swedish at all?
Rarely.
Very rarely, yeah.
We write. We never think in Swedish when we write. No. It's always in English.
I kind of always think in English.
Why country? Why this country sound? Because it's becoming more and more popular. And more, we're interviewing lots more bands who have adopted this style.
Yeah, I don't know.
A lot of people
love it. Kind of are into this folk and country.
So. I mean, I think because so much music nowadays is so electronic, and I think people kind of. I know. I do. Like, I really long to hear like human voices and just like very simple.
Going back to basics.
Yeah,
almost.
Yeah. And I mean, that's what we've always loved. And.
Well, you've done it beautifully, Florence. Clara, Johanna,
thank you.
Because we really enjoyed that. The whole studio was mesmerised. So thank you.
Thank you
very much.
First Aid Kit's latest album is called Stay Gold.
Now, that's it.